Yes, so okay, thank you, Shwari. So my name is Theo van Walsum. I'm an associate professor in the bigger group. And in my theme group focuses on image guidance in interventions and therapy. So the work in my group is minimally invasive interventions. So these are interventions where this theme group is really application oriented. We want to contribute to interventions and therapy and decision making in therapy. And the background are minimally invasive interventions. These interventions have been demonstrated to be good for the patients. Tiny incisions, people recover faster, they go back to work faster. So also for economy, it's good. But these advantages for the patients come at the expense of the physician, because in these minimally invasive interventions, you don't have direct eyesight often, you don't have good tactile feedback, so that makes these interventions more difficult for the physician. For the lack of direct eyesight, sometimes the physicians use imaging during the intervention. For example, in interventional radiology or interventional cardiology, X-ray or ultrasound is being used to image the tissue, the target tissue, the target lesion, and also the instruments. Sometimes also CT is used, which is not really a real-time modality, but still can be used to guide the physician during interventions. So the objective of the work in my group is to improve use images to improve the guidance and decision-making in minimally invasive interventions. And there are basically three focus areas in this research line. One is image-based navigation, and that relates to guidance, and also augmented reality that also relates to guidance, and also on decision making during interventions. And I will illustrate each of these focus areas. So traditionally, for minimally invasive interventions, navigation systems are being used. This is an example of a neuro navigation system, and with these systems, the physician can see, let's say, the position of the tip of the instrument together with a preoperative image. For example, to know where to open the skull to excise a tumor, or to even see where to cut through the brain tissue in case the tumor is visually not discernible from normal brain tissue. So these type of systems work well in let's say, neurosurgery or orthopedics, because the tissue involved, bone or the skull, doesn't deform much during intervention. And in this image-based navigation research line, what you try to do is to develop similar approaches, so integrating images that are obtained before the intervention, to use these during the intervention to guide the physician. And what you need to deal with is the deformation. If you work for liver, the liver can deform, the liver can move during intervention. So how do you deal with these changing anatomy? And how can you use interoperative imaging to solve that? So this is an example of one of the applications that we're working on. On the left, you see a diagnostic image of the liver, and in red is a lesion, a tumor, which is also visible in the scan. I now draw it, but it's also visible in the scan. At the right, you see an image that's obtained during intervention where a needle is introduced to ablate this lesion. In this image, you don't see the tumor because no contrast is given, and it cannot really be given in these images. So what you want to do is link both images, so to align them, so that such that you can bring the tumor position information to the image with the needle, such that you can see whether your needle is at the right location. So this has been developed already in a tool that is now being tested in the clinic, and there are several things that still can be improved in this tool. So we have projects in this line, also using ultrasound instead of CT imaging. The next guidance topic is augmented reality. This shows two images of navigation systems, and what you could see here is that the physicians look at the screen. The information is on the screen, and whereas their hands are in the working area at a different location. It's kind of a which sometimes is difficult because you have hand-eye coordination issues. And it would be ideal if you can project all the information from the screen in the field of view of the surgeon, let's say, on top of the patient. And that's what we're working on in this area, where we try to use augmented reality to bring the information from the screen to the patient, basically. So what you can see here is an example of a skull projected on top of a phantom skull, and you can also see an instrument which is augmented. You can see the tip of the instrument, even if the instrument is behind other structures. And these are examples of augmented reality generated images and visualizations that were obtained by a master's student who did a project in this direction. So this is the second area, augmented reality. And the third area is therapeutic decision making. These are two images from a stroke treatment. Stroke is a very relevant topic, and recently a new stroke treatment has been shown to be effective, but still lots is unknown on the treatment itself, and also which patient should be treated with this method. So for example, this is an image where there is some treatment done. What you can see is that there are more vessels visible, but what the physician doesn't know is, am I done? Are there more vessels to be opened or not? And we are developing technologies to support the physician in this decision making, both using DSA images, so these are images acquired at the intervention, and also using CTA images, which are acquired just before the intervention, which could be used for patient selection, so selecting the patients that need to be treated. So to summarize, in this research line, there are three types of applications that we're working on. One is multimodal image guidance. The example is on RF ablation. There are other applications that you also work on. The next is augmented reality navigation for neuro, for also cranial maxillofacial surgery. And the third is decision making in interventions. And these are the applications, and we are, let's say, from technology point of view, we don't have a strong preference. We are looking for those methods that work. So we're using both traditional methods and also modern deep learning methods. We use those that we think are most appropriate for the application. And this ends my presentation. So more concrete project proposals will be discussed in the chat room in the afternoon in the number B, IGIT. That's the chat room where projects related to this research line will be discussed.